by evidence, because we don't know who's taking.
That is not an evidence.
We can only say somebody is taking. We don't know this. You didn't live to buy the newspaper, so how can you tell the demography?
But I'm simply saying, when you make a statement...
You didn't live to buy the newspaper, so she can't tell the secret.
I'm only addressing your point. When you said,
I'm only saying it.
No. When you said, nobody created.
We don't know. Maybe.
Please. Can I address your point?
The aliens created from Mars.
Please.
Maybe the aliens created. From
Let's
Mars.
Address your
How
point.
How do you know it's not aliens? Let's, that created.
Shall we address your point that you just stated?
Okay. Tell
when
me.
You make a statement, yes. A claim, nobody made it. It is a positive claim. Needs backing up with evidence. Your evidence is, I don't know, no one knows. Then the statement has no value. It's meaningless as a statement to be reckoned with. Because when you say nobody knows, this statement comes from for everyone else's ignorance. That is not evidence for your statement. If I say that watch was made by, say, Loros. I know it's not Loros, it's a very expensive watch, right? And he said, how do I know? I can then provide evidence to that statement.
Because this watch was made here now, in present time. You're telling me that it was made 2,000 years ago. It wasn't born 2,000 years ago, and it didn't live 2,000 years ago.
The statement... Listen, we need to understand something, right?
Yeah, okay. It's right to
understand something. This tree didn't exist forever.
Well, we have trees that... It's been around for 800 years.
That particular, look at the back. That tree over
there. You know how old that tree is?
That tree, did it exist forever?
I don't know. Some trees live.
No, that one, that particular one. It's easy to answer that question. You know what? We can cut the tree and we can see the rings.
Yeah.
And we can count how many, because rings tell us the age of the tree.
Yeah.
Yeah? So it's easy. So we know that tree wasn't in existence forever.
Yeah.
Everything within this universe.
Yeah. It's called life circulation.
Everything within this universe.
Yeah.
You did not create it. Did you create the sun and the moon?
We don't know who that is. Because we didn't have it on the camera in person to create.
When you say you, we don't know, who are we?
Who are we? We're human beings.
No.
That's why we don't know.
When you bring we as in your statement, we don't know, obviously you have some people in mind. You and someone else.
Yeah.
But I know we created it, good. So obviously I'm not part of your we.
Okay, that's you. Okay, that's
yeah.
Your opinion.
So that means
no,
not opinions. Remember, when you said we don't know, you are referring to a group of people with you.
Because I know a lot of people with me will have the same.
But I am saying I do not agree with your statement. I know who created this universe. I know who created this tree, the planets, the sun, and the moon.
I mean, it's good to believe in something.
It's not about belief. It's about knowledge.
It's a knowledge.
Yeah. Let me ask you a question, right? Do you think nothing can make something?
Nothing can make something. It depends what you call nothing.
Nothing is the absence of everything. Can it make something?
It depends what you call nothing.
Yeah, absence of everything.
Absence of anything. Can make, and do you think the absence of anything can make nothing?
The absence of everything, which is nothing, cannot make anything. Cannot make anything. Because to make something, it needs to exist, first of all. It needs to have some properties like energy. Nothing has none of these, so you cannot make anything. So if you are something now, is it possible that back in the past, sometime in the past, there was absolute nothingness? Is it possible? Is it even possible to entertain the idea that at one point in the past, there was absolutely nothing?
I'll tell you something. I personally think there was something not of God, okay? I wouldn't believe that personally. That's what I think. That's my opinion, you know? And I respect the people who actually do believe, because it's a good thing to believe into something good, you know? And, you know, no religion says bad about something. We all want people to be nice, but I think we all get people to, you know, years ago, you know, there was no person like, say, like somebody had to go around and tell people to do these things, because everyone was crazy, everyone was going mental, you know, this world was going mental, you know, so somebody had to go around and tell people to do this, do that, you know, just to be
but
nice.
You have come to this realization, there's something who's made everything. Is that what you're saying?
Human made, yeah. Human made, just like
human made.
Yeah.
Humans haven't been living in this world for long. Before humans, the earth existed. So did other creatures.
Yeah.
So the humans didn't make...
Maybe we came from different planet.
When you start saying maybe, planet. Then...
How do you know?
No, when you say maybe...
We finally got to that point where you find a new planet, a load of water. How
do you know how we become certain? Huh? When we have all these questions about maybe.
Because I personally believe we all come from different planets.
And the evidence for your assertion?
Evidence for... Just like what we go into now, new planets now, and discovering new things, you know. So why have we got so many different planets? Why there's not God on a different planet? Why there's no? Do you know there's not God in a different planet?
What do you mean God? God created everything, right? What? Including all those planets.
How many
and
million
more?
Planets?
And
how many millions of planets? There's billions of planets.
It's probably innumerable.
And do you believe there's a life in a different planet?
Possible.
Possible.
Yeah.
And do you believe that God's?
God will sustain them as well, yeah. And guide them, yeah. And nourish them, yes.
You believe that?
Yeah. In fact, one of the things that you will be astonished to read in the very first chapter
Why can't we go today, man? Why can't
No, because we haven't got the technology yet. Okay, you need to wisen up.
Well, why does God not give us the technology to go to this?
God created us, our brains, to toil and to use our brains to develop all the tools.
Okay.
Right.
So we
otherwise, look, we'll be lazy. God doesn't want us to become lazy. So one of the astonishing things that you will find in the Quran, it starts by saying Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Praise and gratitude belongs to God, the Lord of all the worlds. The first statement that you hear, all worlds.
Tell me one science.
The earth is not the one of the worlds. There are many worlds out there.
Tell me one scientist that is believing.
We know there are lots of other planets. We know there are other galaxies.
What's your evidence of a God?
Tell me the one scientist.
Let's understand. When you say evidence for God, you see, when people ask this question, what's the evidence for a God? We need to understand why people are asking. The evidence of God is obvious. It is ingrained within us. It's within...
That's not evidence, you're just making...
No, I'm not saying...
I could just say that
now. Allow me to elaborate. What's the evidence for something that is obvious?
It's not obvious, though, is it?
Okay.
Hang on.
Just a moment, right? Right. When we say God, we need to understand what we mean. It is not a God where, you know, he says, you know, just to dispel the myth about the concept of God that we have as Muslims. Because people often misunderstand our concept of God, and then this question becomes raised. But if you understood our concept of God, you will then agree with us. The question, asking this question about the evidence is meaningless. Let me tell you what God isn't in the sense that we believe in. It's not a God that he leaves his son on guard to watch his wife in a particular house, and then he found his son didn't do that and he chops his son's head off. This God, try to understand, right? The concept of... I am going to answer.
You're going a little bit too
I am not going too far. I'm going to address it.
I'm just curious what your evidence is of your God.
Look, I'm going to say the reason why this question is sometimes meaningless to us is for the following reasons.
It's not meaningless
but
to me.
If you don't hear me out, then you wouldn't know why I say this.
You know the tribes who live in the Amazon?
They believe in a supreme being. Yes, they did. So they believed in God.
Tribes believe in God.
Okay, can I address the ladies?
They believe in power.
Excuse me, if you allow me to address, okay, thank you.
Because I'm interested, right. I want to know what you're saying.
Okay, so what I'm saying is, when you say God, I have to define to you what I mean by God. Because my God is not a being.
What's your God then?
So I'll define you by what he isn't, then you'll appreciate it.
Can't you tell me what he is?
I will, but I want to do a contrast. It's important.
I've run for a lot of time.
You see, if you think asking about God exists or not doesn't even deserve 5 minutes of our time, then what can I say?
Okay. Right, 5 minutes, just hear him out.
No, I don't really care that much.
She doesn't care that much. That's all I'm going to say. There are people out there, the reason they don't believe in God is because they don't care. Carelessness is what drives them to disbelieve in God. Okay, that's the point I was going to make anyway. But when people ask about evidence, it's because you care less with the evidence that is so abound. God's existence is self-evident.
If you don't look at the evidence, then how are you actually going to analyze it? So there you go. That shows their disbelief.